Detroit rapper Eminem cancels his sold-out European tour to check himself into rehab after admitting an addiction to sleep medication. We'll have more on this story as it develops.
Shady Records recording artist Obie Trice has apparently survived a gunshot to the head in what appears to be a random drive-by shooting, while Eminem is rumored to be on and off again relationship with
just in, a tour bus involving Eminem's on.
Updating a story we brought you earlier about gunfire at an after-hours club, we've learned that the rapper Proof has been fatally shot.
Shady Aftermath recording artist,
longtime best friend of Eminem and a member of the rap group D12.
Back in the news again today.
Is it a sabbatical or the end? The rumors and speculation continue to swirl around Eminem. He insists he's just taking a break, but doubters believe he's retiring. Leaving us all to ask, will the real Slim Shady please stand up?
So this is it. This is what I wish for, just isn't how I envisioned it. Fame to the point of imprisonment. I just thought the shit would be different, but something changed the minute that I got a whiff of it. I started to inhale it, smell it, started sniffing it, and it became my cocaine. I just couldn't quit, I just wanted a little bit. Then it turned me to a monster, I became a hypocrite. Concert after concert, I was raking in the dough, rolling in green. Had the game hemmed up like a sewing machine, but I was losing my freedom. There was nowhere for me to not go and be seen, and just go and be me, and there was no in between. You either loved it or hated. Every CD, critics gave it a 3. Then 3 years later, they go back and re-rate it and call the Slim Shady LP the greatest. The Marshall Mathers was a classic. The Eminem show was fantastic, but Encore just didn't have the caliber to match it. I guess enough time just ain't passed yet. A couple more years, that shit'll be illmatic, and 8 years later, I'm still at it. Divorce, remarried, a felon, a father, sleeping pill addict. And this is real talk, I feel like the Incredible Hulk. My back has been broke and I can still walk.
So be careful what you wish for, cause you just might get it. And if you get it, then you just might not know what to do with it, cause it might just come back on you tenfold. I said be careful what you wish for, cause you just might get it. And if you get it, then you just might not know what to do with it, cause it might just come back on you tenfold.
I got a letter from a fan that said he's been praying for me every day, and for some reason it's been weighing on my mind heavy. Cause I don't read every letter I get, but something told me to go ahead and open it. But why would someone pray for you when they don't know you? You didn't pray for me when I was local. And as I lay these vocals, I think of all the shit I had to go through just to get to where I'm at. I've already told you at least 1,000 times in these rhymes I appreciate the prayer, but I've already got God on my side, and it's been one hell of a ride, hasn't it? Just watch it from an opposite standpoint. Man, boys got to look nuts, and that's the only word I can think of right now on how to describe this shit. It's just like a vibe you get, go ahead and pop to it. Just watch what you wish for, cause I got the shit.
So be careful what you wish for, cause you just might get it. And if you get it, then you just might not know what to do with it, cause it might just come back on you tenfold. I said be careful what you wish for, cause you just might get it. And if you get it, then you just might not know what to do with it, cause it might just come back on you tenfold.
CDs ain't selling no more anyways, man. Look at SoundScan. I really don't think it matters.
Everything I do is number one. That makes you two, and that spells trouble for me and you. Cause that's how beef starts between crews. And I don't mind if I debut at number two. So why do you? If we make money, then why can't you be satisfied with what you do?
It's like our legacy's pregnant, we're planting eggs every record. They're begging me to release a CD every other second, but don't expect it, cause every time I get hit with that question, I just deflect it. Get cash as a 50s record and check it, and buck us out. Now get these motherfuckers out before I smack them. Plus the artist dropped an album, now go out and get that one. And I got a whole stable of artists who's able and fully capable of holding a label till I figure out when I'm ready to drop, or maybe not. Shady, look how hot you were on top. You were pop, you were so popular. Now you're not, you're a washed up entrepreneur. How's it possible? Well, it's not. If you're a little fickle, mine's with a cut on, but you didn't. See, I don't rap for the green, I mean, I ain't greedy. But I also know what it's like to be needy, you
and I will never go back to poverty. See, it ain't easy to try to step away from entertainment, separated from CDs. And every day, it just seems like we're beefing. Even the media is meat eaters. They gotta give you something to read. You won't buy it, believe what you wanna believe. Let them feed you the BS. P.S. Peace to T.I. You gon' be alright. We out. Peace.
On the syllables, just a little, but still I feel I should kill a few just to show that still I do put forth and effort with foot forward. Thank heavens and good lord, whoever would have thought that my envelope cord would have been cut from this is the same cloth. There's no other name, just be thankful that I came forth. Temper the same, whether it's boiled or flame broiled. You say my name, you read that ass, you gon' pay for it. Just the respect, it's not the crown that I came for. But if you feel like passing it around, well then Jay throw it. This way I'll go straight toward it, if not I'll just wait for it. Fell off the skateboard, got a couple of scrapes, forget about it. Now I'm stuck in this fraud, but I'll get about it. I always do, I ain't gon' sit here and argue about it. I came up out of that gutter, I just crawled through about it. I'm back, I'm sorry, I feel awful about it.
But when you can't sleep and you're still up, I get the ball and I'm like, rip, you can't get a grip. You probably got stripped, wanna rumble, no reason to trip. I grab it like Gnarls Barkley, holds a mic, it's Gnarls Barkley. I smile like Charles Barkley, come on, I'm hard, Barkley. Ain't booing, ain't pursuing, no lawsuits, I ain't suing. I know what I'm doing, give me the ball and your life is ruined. I'm like Rashid, I remind me of the spirit of proof. I'm happy, go lucky, fall in a groove and I'm on the move. I'm smooth with it, give me the ball, you don't know what to do with it. Shoot it in the basket, you other teams need a casket. LeBron said, don't respond, there's no back and forth. This game is mental, man, I play a lot, I walk away and just hustle the crowd. You tryna touch, sit down. Hold me like I told you this is. Man, I don't think you're ready. I get the crowd rolled up like a U-Haul truck. Just call me Two Ball Chuck. Ain't too tall, what? I'll leave you tall stuck. Man, I love this game. Who the hell you called up? You need points on the paint? I'm in joints when they stay. All my coins in the bank, and we're going all the way. Yeah, baby, it's true. I'm talking to you. You already know what to do. Just pass it to me. It just so happens to be that I adapt when it's heat. So strap in your seat. I got a grasp on this beat. You ain't convinced? Give it to Tayshaun Prince. We haven't stayed calm since. Lead the ball with delayed palm prints. Hey, now hold me this. Hold me this. Hold me. I told you this is. Man, I don't think you're ready. We get everybody involved, homie. We get everybody involved. I said, we get everybody involved, homie. We get everybody involved.
Give me the ball. You gotta block me before you cry. Tell me you ain't listening. Like, that's one of the requirements of having to get on Shady Records or G-Unit Records, you know what I'm saying, or Aftermath, is you got to be able to rap. You know what I'm saying? And the way the game is now, it's like everybody and their brother and their mother and their brother's mother's cousin can rap. And it's accepted. People are accepting it.
End of message.
It is not about lyrics anymore. It's about a hot beat and a catchy hook.
I'm a little nutty and I know it, but if you go back and take a look at my history, you will see that I am not the only one who's off his rocker. There were many before me. I was always labeled the black sheep of the family with a bad seed I grow to be. But if you take a look at us now, you see the apple didn't fall too far from the tree.
Alright, look, I'ma tell you the story from my side. Maybe you'll understand. Check it out.
You done witnessed unexplainable shit. Too insane to explain. People run from what they just don't get. Maybe say they should've just hit him with a little bit. Did I spit too soon? Should I spoon fed him it? But I was just so eager to prove I was even worth being in the same league or the room of the people of whom I was in. Every now and then I look up like I was seeking approval. Was it because of the pigment on my skin, or was it a figment of my imagination? Maybe it bothered me more than it did them. Maybe it wasn't a big deal back then, but to me it was. See, what it was I developed a complex from being judged. Who spit his verse? Now I'm next to see who barks. I'm in the booth staring back to see who's marks. I get a reaction from. Usually the first thumb was for proof, and the rest of the group backed him up. And no one lied to each other, cause none of us had deals. It was real, we just wanted tickets for that meal.
Sometimes I feel like it's just me. Sometimes I feel like I'm going crazy. But take a look at my family, cause the apple don't fall too far from the tree. I said sometimes I feel like it's just me. Sometimes I feel like I'm going crazy. But take a look at my family, cause the apple don't fall too far from the tree.
Ever since my mother was pregnant with a second egg, cause she said that I had a baby sister who fell out of the window. I was too young to remember Kansas City projects. I was like 5'6" and how come I remember math? Isaac and Boogie, if it was the projects in Missouri, cause those were my best friends until Isaac took my tricycle and my Uncle Ty went to try to go get it back and ended up getting jumped and cut in the gut with a switch and 70 some stitches, which is to this day when my mother still tries to show me some old fake picture of a fictitious little sister who never existed. And this is why part of my life so twisted, but I could never be as sick as that bitch is. And by the way, that bitch is one of my relatives.
Sometimes I feel like it's just me. Sometimes I feel like I'm going crazy. But take a look at my family, cause the apple don't fall too far from the tree. I said sometimes I feel like it's just me. Sometimes I feel like I'm going crazy. But take a look at my family, cause the apple don't fall too far from the tree.
You probably have to peel back layers upon layers of pain to see why everything I say is so insane. What's different about my brain that separates me from other players in this game? On the surface it may seem like a scheme or some sort of scam for me to get some damn sympathy, but that's the last thing I need is for people to walk around feeling sorry for me. And I'm not a G, never claimed to be. I gave my best to cash, just this whole beat. Don't need it more than me, but we'll see, cause we ain't looking for beef. But if it comes our way, what do we turn the other cheek? Come on.
Sometimes I feel like it's just me. Sometimes I feel like I'm going crazy. But take a look at my family, cause the apple don't fall too far from the tree. I said sometimes I feel like it's just me. Sometimes I feel like I'm going crazy. But take a look at my family, cause the apple don't fall too far from the tree.
Yeah, and I'm the crazy one, right?
I still remember the hip-hop shop days. All I ever wanted was to get props, not praise. A couple lives
the shit got hazy. Then we made a song called Mama, My Name Is. And it skipped right over hip-hop and the hip-hop stations. Top 40 or radio, the kid got famous. He made it, but this was just not the way this was supposed to go. I'm afraid to say this.
Thanks, it's been real. I love you, but I just can't deal with the stress this game is giving me. But before I go, you know I can't close this show without no closure, so before I leave.
Yeah, I just wanna take the time out right now, man, to basically say rest in peace to Deshaun Holton. That's my heart, man. Dr. Dre, for giving me the opportunity just to even listen to me, to get me to this point. I want to thank Jimmy Iovine, Interscope, Aftermath, everybody at the whole Shady staff, everybody who's basically supporting me from day one. Paul Rosenberg, Tracy McNew. You know I love you guys. I couldn't do it without you, man. D12, Cassius, you gonna be a beast when you get out there, man. Trust me, homie. My ears don't lie to me. Who else am I forgetting? Oh yeah, Obi Trice, Bobby Creekwater, and basically, man, the whole city of Detroit, 8 Mile Road, for making me what I am today. Which basically goes back to proof. D12, I love you guys, man. Runyon Ave, for holding me down when shit got thick. Oh, wouldn't be complete if I didn't thank my mom, bitch. So.
Thanks, it's been real. I love you, but I just can't deal with the stress this game is giving me. But before I go, you know I can't close this show without no closure, so before I leave.
So.
Thanks, it's been real. I love you, but I just can't deal with the stress this game is giving me. But before I go, you know I can't close this show without no closure, so before I leave.
And I really don't want to grasp, but I specialize in eating and season and hear more the words of a local JSC would say.
I'm a goat. And for those of y'all who don't know what a GOAT is, it means the greatest of all time, and I consider myself one of those, so thank you very much, here it goes.
This is the part I was worried about. Everyone thinks that my career is down the tubes, and I'm in some dusty garage, inhaling them carbon monoxide fumes, and everyone's telling me what I should do and how I should come out of what to rap about. And I know that I got a lot up in my Abdullah Abdangada that I gotta get out, and I'm not sure how this is gonna come off. They're probably gonna think that I'm coming off as cocky. Like I just started giving a fuck what you really think about me. See, the thing about me is you don't really know a thing about me. Everyone's making a think about me, like there's some kind of an aura of that of the king around me. Surround me with other big gangsters, killers and bangers, and the most dangerous criminals. And I feel like I'm more comfortable around them than I do my own motherfucking neighbors. But see, my genius to be remembered is one of the best when I leave. But why does it seem like I'm not even put up in the same category as other MCs? So when Weezy says that he's better than Jay-Z, please be that just subliminally. Means he thinks Jig is the best and that he's the only one up in that league, see? And it's easy just to consider me one of the greatest white rappers there is, knowing goddamn well that I'm one of the best motherfucking rappers who ever lived.
I'm a GOAT, and I don't mean to gloat, but I know what I know and I know what you're thinking. These magazines, I'll never put it in ink, because how would it look if they considered me as a GOAT? And for those of y'all who don't know what a GOAT is, it means the greatest of all time, and I consider myself one of those, so thank you very much, here it goes.
Maybe they figure that I'm on my way out the game, so they gotta go try to find them a new Eminem or a new Shady. If they think it's gonna happen, man, I thought I was crazy. Or maybe I could be taking it wrong, and they're trying to pay homage to me in a strange way. So let me pay homage to my fellow white competitors almost in the same way. See, you hardly ever do hear anyone even bringing up Paul Wall's white, cause Lyrically, he doesn't pose a threat to anyone, see, he's just alright. And Bubba Sparks, he just won't write, because he's so caught up in that Snow White. The Timberland can't even get him in the studio, he's still going off that coke, right? And it's so sad, because he's dope, right? America's next great white hope, right? So now they feel like they gotta come up with some corny ass white rabbit show, right? And which I'm still having mixed feelings about. They said to be real, I'm just spilling it out. There's something about a white boy talking black and running around with a damn grill in his mouth. And I love when they say that Tiger Woods shit. Isn't it ironic that the best rapper's white and the best golfer's black? And I'm the one who's gotta catch all the flack over that. But these are the people who never had heard of an Eminem until 8 Mile that came out. But I had already hit middle America. Parents just all got to liking me now. And suddenly I wasn't such a bad guy. All that I hate you for me must have died. Thought I committed career suicide, so I had to turn back into the bad guy. So faggoty, 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 gays anatomy guy made Raggedy Ann and Andy. Not Raggedy Andy and Andy and Andy. And Angelina Jolie is just another hoe. And Brad is a sucker because once I fuck her, she wants to go to Somalia to adopt another baby. You know what I say? No. You better say some of them kiss from Madonna. She needs all the publicity she can get. You want a shady? Well, you got it, man. I ain't apologizing for shit. I'ma go. And I don't mean to glow, but I know what I know and I know what you think. And these magazines, I'll never put it in ink, because how would it look if they considered me as a goat? And for those of y'all who don't know what a goat is, it means the greatest of all time, and I consider myself one of those. So thank you very much. Here it goes. Man, I'm taking my ball and going home, man. This shit is too easy. Nobody wants to even pass me the ball, cause I'm a goat. So don't worry, I'm out the motherfucking game. And y'all can sit and argue about who's the motherfucking best, but y'all know that I'm a goat. And like I said, I'm one of the motherfucking best. Before you get your panties in a motherfucking bunch. But before I go, I'd like to say fuck you very much to everybody who wasn't there from the start. And thank you very much to everybody who was. And you only gotta say it, just think it. Cause I know that you know that I know that you know that I know that
I'm a goat.
I'm out, y'all. It's been real.
I'm a goat.